What I'm excited about?
What are you excited about? Throw that football?
The end zone. Woo! There he is, folks.
Why not be excited? Because we have reached the final month of the regular season in the high school football ranks. I'll tell you what, there is no time to lose. Let's tee this thing up, and we are going to kick off week 7 of the end zone. We start in the Badger South with undefeated Milton hosting Monroe. Monroe's Max Golombowski rolls left, finds Tyler Matley. It's going to put him in the red zone here with this pitch and catch. So they're knocking on the door, and how about breaking through to the other side? Nick Bansley takes a handoff, gets it into the end zone, extending the lead to 27-6 right there. Milton trying to put some points on the board just before half, but Monroe's Tyler Matley picking off the pass. He even gets a nice gain on the return, and the Cheesemakers hand Milton their first loss of the season, 34-28. In the Swall, undefeated Mineral Point hosting La Crosse Aquinas. It is Mineral Point striking first. Isaac Lindsay connecting with Liam Stump in the end zone. That short pass put him up 7-0. Doesn't take long for Aquinas to answer back, though Gavin Wetzel forces himself into the end zone. We're all knotted up 7-0 in the first quarter. Start off the second quarter on a good note for Mineral Point, though. Isaac Lindsay again, this time taking the ball himself 15 yards into the end zone. They were up 13-7, missed the extra point. It didn't matter. Pointers on point tonight, 52-22 the final. Undefeated Lodi had to move their game to Wanakee tonight due to field conditions. The Blue Devils hosting Columbus. Lodi gets started first here. Lucas Hayroth punching his way into the end zone. One score lead, but Columbus answers back. William Cotter airing out the long ball. Tegan Urshlib comes down with it. He is taken down at the 17-yard line, but Cotter hits Urshlib again. This time it's a touchdown connection. They wouldn't let up. Columbus hands Lodi their first loss of the season, 14-10. In the Rock Valley, one loss, Edgerton playing host to 4-2 East Troy. Edgerton's Ethan Krause takes the handoff for a big gainer. It's going to end up inside the red zone. So after he's finally brought down here with the slip, it's Krause a few plays later taking it. This time he fumbles the football but recovers it for a touchdown. Edgerton's Drew Hansen then scrambling around. He's going to find Nick Spang here for a 26-yard gain. That would set up another scoring opportunity. This time they end up turning to the leg of Ismael Diaz. He would hit a field goal to extend the lead to 10-0 first quarter, and East Troy never scored. Edgerton wins 34-0. Now everyone in the Rock Valley entered the day chasing unbeaten Evansville. Alec Osmus at our game of the week at Evansville High School.
There's a unique story taking place this season with the Evansville Blue Devils. Last year they went winless, 0-9 on the season, but this year have done a complete 180. Tonight, their homecoming against Bigfoot turned out to be their 7th straight win of this season. Offensively, the Blue Devils have been lighting up the scoreboard. They've put up at least 40 points in 6 of their 7 games. Tonight, Evansville scored on 3 straight possessions early in the first half, on their way to a 40-14 win.
We don't love winning. We just don't want to lose again because last year was rough. I'm very grateful for our seniors this year. They're taking leadership very seriously.
You know, it's just really good after going 0-9 last year, you know, to see what's so good to actually be winning again and, you know, playing as a team.
With the win tonight, Evansville, they improved to 7-0 and remain on top of the Rock Valley Conference. Not bad for a squad that went winless a year ago. In Evansville, for our game of the week, Alec Osmus for 27 Sports.